The Lagos state government's proposed 38-kilometer-long fourth mainland bridge connects Lagos Island to Itumaga in Ikorodu via Langbasa, Lekki, and Beiku, Ikorodu, across the Lagos Lagoon. The bridge is a cross-sectional road with a 2x4-lane carriageway and permission for a BRT lane and future road contraction. It is expected to be the second longest bridge in Africa, with 3 toll plazas, 9 interchanges, a 4.5-kilometer lagoon bridge, and an eco-friendly environment, among other features. The bridge has been under discussion since 2003. A concept design for the project was produced by Nigerian architect and urban planner NLA. It created a concept design for a 2-level bridge that would be part of the city's ring road. This ring road will provide alternate traffic routes from Lekki to Ikorodu and Aicha to Aja, relieving the third mainland bridge's overstressed capacity. With this improved flow of people across Lagos, the city will be relieved of traffic congestion, will be able to capitalize on its numerous opportunities, and will grow more rapidly. The government of Senator Bola Ahmed Tinubu, former governor of Lagos State, conceptualized the idea. Construction was set to begin in 2017, 50 years after the state's inception and 26 years after the ex-military president Ibrahim Babangida delivered the third mainland bridge. It was expected to be completed by 2019, but had not been started as of April 13, 2020. The project was estimated to cost the state $844 billion in the 2017 budget. The Lagos state government proposed an additional $2.2 billion for construction in September 2020. 800 houses are expected to be demolished, as opposed to the 4,000 previously designated for demolition in the realigned design. Welcome to ThinkRich Media, the community which brings to you entrepreneurial, business, and personal development content to inform, motivate, and inspire you. We also want to introduce you to our special African development playlist because we strongly believe entrepreneurship, rather than global pity, is the key to Africa's growth and development. So if you're African and you aren't subscribed to our community, you're missing out. The Fourth Mainland Bridge is a proposed 38-kilometer-long bridge initiative by the Lagos state government connecting Lagos Island by way of Lekki, Langbasa, and Beiku towns and across Lagos Lagoon to Itumaga in Ikorodu Park. On completion of the project is expected to become the longest bridge in Africa. The freeway bridge is subdivided into 3 sections, namely Island Section, Lagoon Section, and Mainland Section. It starts at the Abraham and Asanya roundabout in Lekki, where a free-flow interchange will be constructed, as well as some traffic flow alterations to the existing Lekki EP expressway so as to maintain traffic movements during construction. In April 2020, 10 companies, mainly dominated by Chinese firms, were shortlisted to construct the project out of 32 bidders. The announcement of the shortlisted firms was made in a statement by the Ministry of Works and Infrastructure. A joint venture between China Jiaoba Group and the China Geoengineering Corporation. China Harbor Engineering. A design for the bridge has been pitched, with the first stakeholders meeting on environmental and social impact assessment for the construction and launch of the bridge's logo on September 20, 2020. Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu, Minister of Works and Housing, Mr. Babatunde Rajifeshola, and Minister of State for Environment, Mrs. Sharon Ikazer, all spoke at the first stakeholders meeting on the bridge's environmental and social impact assessment, which took place at the Adami Barrow Auditorium Secretariat in Alausa, Aicha. They requested the residents' cooperation and support in order to make the project a reality. In his address, Governor Sanwo-Olu, represented at the occasion by his deputy, Dr. Obafemi Hamzat, assured Lagosians that the project would be less destructive, affirmed that it has been well integrated to the overall master plan of the state in relation to transportation infrastructure, adding that the project allows for the first time direct access from the large suburb of Ikorodu to the island and the Lekki Free Trade Zone area. Dr. Kadri Obeifi-Hamzat described the event as a significant one in the joint effort to change the narrative of the socioeconomic development of the state. Through the provision of critical infrastructure for sustainable prosperity, he stressed that the Fourth Mainland Bridge project was deliberately included during their electioneering campaign as a key deliverable in their manifesto, while noting that the present administration has left no stone unturned in ensuring that the strategic project becomes a reality. Sanmoalu disclosed that the state government reactivated the construction of the bridge in October 2019, with the development of a six-step process that will lead to the selection of a suitable concessionaire in line with global best practices. Deputy Governor Dr. Femi Hamzat stressed that engagement and consultation on environmental and social impact assessment is a precursor to the third step, which will involve issuing a request for proposal to the six consortia, who will be required to present their respective financial proposals and methodologies for carrying out the project. It will be concluded with the selection of the preferred bidder and two reserved bidders. This is as the government is at the conclusion stage in the bidding process for the award of contract for the bridge, which is conceived in the Lagos State Master Plan. As an administration, he said, the government decided to upgrade the project and develop a method to deliver this strategic piece of highway infrastructure, and have since left no one in doubt about our commitment to ensure that this project becomes a reality. According to him, the history of the Fourth Mainland Bridge project goes back almost 15 years when it was first raised due to the ever-decreasing efficiency of the existing Third Mainland Bridge in addressing the transportation needs of a growing population. The Third Mainland Bridge, he said, was the first real piece of strategic infrastructure deployed in Lagos Metropolis, and the proponents and developers of that project should be commended for their vision. Without the Third Mainland Bridge, Lagos today is simply unimaginable. He urged stakeholders to use the meeting to consult among themselves on the steps to take in order to remove all bottlenecks that may hinder the delivery of the Fourth Mainland Bridge. He stated that all aspects of Lagos mobility must be considered, including road planning, public transportation integration, and urban freight, strengthening the current radial commuting connections towards the Lagos urban core, and establishing transversal connections that will serve both long-distance traffic, avoiding metropolitan traffic, and other connections within the megacity. While giving assurances of his unalloyed support towards the project, the Minister for Works and Housing and former Governor of the state, Mr. Babatunde Rajefeshole. Thank you for watching. If there are any tips you think should be on this list but is not, leave a comment, let us know. Help our channel grow. We hope this video has been helpful to you. Support us by liking the video, subscribing, and turning on your notification.